So another really good question, one where there's quite a bit of research actually being put out there, and one that we've already at the Thrombosis Research Group been engaged in trying to look at this. So it looks like COVID-19 has a number of ways that it impacts blood clotting. When patients contract COVID-19, if they suffer a superimposed either pneumonia or other type of bloodstream infection, they have the risk of going into something called disseminated intravascular coagulation, or DIC. And that's a condition that's associated with bleeding. You consume your platelets, it becomes harder and harder for the body to stop bleeding, and there's a hemorrhagic response. That's really one of the most severe manifestations of a COVID-19 infection with a superimposed bacterial infection or a systemic inflammatory response. For other patients who suffer from COVID-19, the immobility associated with the virus, or the fact that these patients are being admitted to the hospital and or the ICU, will increase the risk of venous thromboembolism in general. There's some suggestion that COVID-19 may rev up the coagulation process by increasing some of the coagulation response. D-dimers are increased in COVID-19 infection. And so that might be a process where there might be a tendency towards a prothrombotic state. But what we think of for the risk of thrombosis in COVID-19 infection really seems to center on the fact that patients are becoming sick, they're hospitalized, they're immobilized, and they may have other comorbidities that make them susceptible to a severe COVID-19 infection that can predispose to DVT or PE.